Hey everybody, Dr. Kranke back. I knew that I had something else to share with you, and again, it's a magazine from my collection. I stopped collecting magazines a few years back because if you collect magazines the way that I was collecting magazines, you quickly realize you're going to need a lot of room. But again, all of this Lowrider building activity sort of got me to look on the shelves, and I found maybe about a year's worth of Lowrider magazines. This is from 2003, and I'm bringing it up and making a mention of it because it is, I mean, all you really need with these magazines is probably a year subscription, and then you could, you could pretty much stop. I ended up stopping, and this is not a criticism of this particular magazine, but I just thought it was just way too many ads, rim ads, and then a lot of, which I, of course, nobody minds, but, you know, just a lot of stuff that what I would call filler, you know, that you want stuff like this when you collect a magazine. You want lots of eye candy, and but it got to be a lot of this stuff, which is fine. That's how they pay their way. Again, it's no criticism, but very few good cars to look at that I like. So, you know, I switched to, I mean, it's just sort of modernized, and to me the Lowriders are for me, and this is just my opinion, I don't want to start a war, Lowriders are really from the 30s and 40s, the bombs, and a little bit into the early 50s, all the way through the 60s with all those beautiful Impalas. So maybe I'm just too old, but I have a particular taste for Lowriders. I don't think just putting, you know, low profile wheels on a vehicle and dropping it makes the vehicle a Lowrider. I mean, there are other factors to it, and so I like this magazine for that reason. It does give you a taste of what the culture was like. I grew up, as many of you know, I grew up in Los Angeles, and in the heyday of the cruising craze, where everybody would go to Hollywood Boulevard and cruise up and down Hollywood Boulevard. And in those days, you had a lot of great Lowriders out on the streets. I think towards the late 70s, early 80s, based on the little research I did, the Japanese and the German collectors came in and literally just spent, however much, they were telling these owners and builders, name the price, just give it to me and I'm taking it. And so a lot of these amazing Lowriders sort of disappeared. And so contemporary builders, they have to work with what they, the 84 Impalas and up, and the Tahoes and the Cadillacs and all of that stuff, that for me, it just sort of took it out of that realm of the Lowrider. But anyway, all this discussion on Lowriders and building them just got me going on wanting to build, and of course, this is the other real reason why I just love those bikes. I had one when I was young, and then, of course, you outgrow a lot of these things. It was a Schwinn, but, you know, this is the stuff that you... that you look at, and even stuff like this, killer green, nice vehicle, nice Cadillac, 93 Cadillac. So you could do, you could get a lot of ideas from a magazine like this. And of course, if you don't have it, you could get it on the stand or subscribe to it. But anyway, it's a great resource for inspiration. And so when it comes to paint, this is what I'm thinking, you know, this is where I'm looking for particular paints and colors. So, and patterns and stuff like that, even though I'm not going to go crazy with a paint job on this one. As I said, right now, it's just, it's going to be a two-tone because I do want to showcase some cranky graphics on it. But anyway, check out Lowrider. It's still around. It's still, you know, a valuable resource. So if you haven't seen it in a few years, you know, pick up a copy. All right, my friends, Dr. Cranky, we'll be back with more Cranky Show.